every year my apple trees do the spring thing. Then through the summer, the leaves got spotty, turn brown, and fall off. Now in September, they think it's spring again. I get no fruit or bad fruit. Can you tell me why and what to do? Thanks, this is Jim Kodak, Tennessee. All right, Mr. D. So it gets the spots, right? Then that's all of a sudden it thinks it's spring again. So what do we think may be the issue?
I think her apple trees, this is her, isn't it? Yeah, this is...
It's Jim.
Jim, okay, Jim, yeah. My apple trees that I don't spray with a regular cover spray do exactly the same thing. a lot of plants do the same thing. When I lived down in Mobile, the pecans that went through hurricanes that were defoliated by hurricane force winds would leave out after the hurricane. And that's not a good thing, because these plants, this time of the, or in the fall of the year, they need to be storing up energy for next year's crop. And if they are putting their energy into these new leaves, then I guarantee you it's hurting next year's crop and it's stressing the plant. Simple answer is to follow a regular spray program. Utilize cover sprays for your apple trees. And that means spraying before bloom. I just happen to have University of Tennessee spray schedule here. That means going with a delayed dormant spray of oil emulsion plus copper. That's when the buds just begin to swell. And then at bud break, Captan, a fungicide, and that will help control the disease called scab. And then just before the blooms open, at first pink, use Captan plus Malathion. You can use an insecticide at that point because the blooms haven't opened. When the blooms open, streptomycin, if you've had a problem with fire blight. And then when the petals have fallen, or when most of the petals have fallen, go with the fungicide Captan or Immunox. Immunox, if you've had a problem with cedar apple rust, plus Malathion insecticide, and then go with that same cover spray of Captan or Immunox plus Malathion, and continue up until just before you harvest. And look at the product that you're using to figure out when you need to stop that. You can use home orchard sprays that are pre-mixed that contain these same ingredients, but I would prefer to mix my own. Some of the home orchard sprays contain carbaryl, and carbaryl will cause apples to throw their crop. And you don't want to use carbaryl on apples.
It also causes the pollinators.
Well, you don't want to spray any insecticide while they're in bloom.
Right.
You do not put any insecticide out at bloom. But follow a spray schedule. Not only will it keep your fruit nice and pretty and clean and free of disease, but it will protect your leaves. Now, you harvest out, depending on when you harvest the apples, after that, you're not spraying afterwards, but that's pretty much, you know, toward the end of the year anyway. And it's not going to be a problem. They're going to start senescing and falling off.
Okay. It's going to be a lot of work. Yeah, read and follow the label.
Yeah.
And we'll have that spray guide, of course, on our website.
That's right.
For you, Mr. Jim. Anything you want to add to that, Doc?
Yeah, one thing.
Okay.
You covered it very thoroughly, but there's one thing, because I had the same thing happen with my pear tree. And one of the more common foliar diseases on apples and things is apple scab. And it just totally defoliates the tree. But one of the things that I have not done yet that I am going to do is rake up all that old dead leaf.
Good sanitation.
Because that stuff overwinters in the old foliage and stuff. So rake all that up, clean up all your leaf litter.
And burn it.
And burn it,
Don't put it in your compost.
Right.
Just destroy it somehow.
That's a good point.
Yeah, practice good sanitation.
Right.
We hope you loved the video. We would love for you to ask more questions. Be sure to leave those questions in your comments.